Proposals to overhaul our outdated planning rules are being welcomed by both developers and environmentalists.
The Resource Management Act faces its biggest shake-up in 30 years, with the introduction of stricter environmental guarantees while promising to get building developments moving faster. Political reporter Mikey Sherman has more details.
The Resource Management Act, fragmented and complex.
About twice the length and size of this report.
Years of concessions and amendments the minister likens to slicing a sausage.
Some people call it the salami effect. You know, there's just a little bit of slice taken off the remaining natural values and the effects of those are minimised for each slice. But in the end, there's been a lot of slices taken off.
Now the salami, known as the RMA, is gone.
Well, I told them so, didn't I? I mean, I told them all that this was going to happen.
After 9 years of making the RMA worse when they were in government, I don't really think they're in a position to preach.
And it seems not in a position to work together.
I wrote to David Parker last year and he sent me back a letter which was only slightly more polite than a two-fingered salute.
Replacing the RMA, two new laws, the Natural and Built Environments Act, promising tougher environmental bottom lines and fewer resource consents.
It's sort of like setting the base framework for what we want the future of our communities and cities to be in New Zealand.
The report does a pretty good job of striking a balance there.
The second law, a new Strategic Planning Act focusing on regions.
That would identify areas that were suitable for development, areas that ought to be protected for natural values.
Meanwhile, the Managed Retreat and Climate Change Act would help relocate properties due to rising sea levels.
That's going to be one of the predominant issues that we have to face. We're living in a climate crisis. It's going to get worse.
Māori input would see a national Māori advisory board and a seat on planning committees, with new legislation giving effect to Te Tiriti o Waitangi. Not that New Zealand First is happy about it.
You're Māori, I've got a Māori background, and I can't stand paternalism and tokenism.
And that wasn't all.
Stand up for real things like a real Māori. Thank you very much.
Just when and how many of today's recommendations will be picked up, we'll now have to wait till after the election. Mikey Sherman, One News.